LA County in the hospital coronavirus. With COVID-19 cases surging, several cruise lines have canceled trips planned for spring and summer. Princess Cruises will now pause all departures through May 14th. Last year, about 100 cruises that were scheduled to visit the Port of LA were canceled due to the pandemic. Experts say the amount of loss in economic activity is about $100 million right there in the LA waterfront. So it's a lot of cash. But I think the cruises will start up again. Who knows when this whole thing will be done, but it will be done. It will be done. Over the weekend, my dream was kept alive. Combined jackpots for Mega Millions and Powerball soared to over $1 billion.
Whoa.
So I go to like this little cigar shop to buy my tickets. There's no one ever in there. It's the guy who owns the place, and I guess people go in there sometimes, buy cigars, or maybe they buy those, what's the other thing I'm thinking of? The e-cigarettes and stuff like that.
Oh, okay, yeah, yeah.
Don't buy those things. But I only go in for the lottery tickets, and he's always so happy to see me. Yeah, you're gonna have the lottery ticket, right? Can you buy me a cigar? I don't smoke cigars, I'm sorry. I just want the lottery tickets, and you're like the easiest place right next door to Albertsons to get them. So I always say to him, I go, hey man, good luck to me and you. Yeah, yeah, you're good luck to me and you, yeah. But I'm like, he gets money if I win. He gets a lot of money if I win, you know?
It sounds like he doesn't know that.
Well, I think he also knows the odds and the fact that you're not going to win.
Yeah, that's what it is, Jill. Friday night's drawing for the Mega Millions produced no grand prize winner, pushing the jackpot to $600 million. And then Saturday night, no winning jackpot for Powerball. That goes to $550 million. It's been years since both games have offered such large prizes. And honestly, I'm not picky. Either one will be fine. Either one is fine. We're going to go in as a team for tomorrow night's draw, right?
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
Good deal. Coming up, anyone else get these phantom vibrations? Thinking your phone is always going off, and all of a sudden your pants is vibrating?
Always.
But you're right? But your phone's not in there.
Pants are vibrating, just to clarify. But yes, always.
What did I say? Pants are vibrating?
You said pants is vibrating.
Right, though? Some people came to his defense saying pants is.
No. But we got into that one, and pants are, because it... We don't have the time for this right now, but it used to be two things. Pants used to be pantaloons, one for each leg, and that term just stuck. So pants are vibrating, not pants is vibrating.
All I will say is, and I appreciate your opinion on this, all I would say, the English language is a living, breathing thing. Always grow. And if my pants are vibrating, my pants are vibrating.
Yeah, that's right. You just said it right.
Oh, darn it. I didn't mean to do that. Why, Belle? Why? Text it right now, 31043.
There's something in the way you roll your eyes. Takes me back to a better time. When I saw everything is good. But now you're the only thing that's good. Trying to stand up on my own two feet. This conversation ain't coming easily. And darling, I know it's getting late. So what do you say we leave this place? Walk me home in the dead of night. I can't be alone with all that's on my mind. So say you'll stay with me tonight. Cause there is so much wrong. Going on. Walk me home in the day tonight.
6:25, Monday, January 11th. Good morning, good morning. My birthday's in 2 days. My wife couldn't remember my age the other day.
Oh, really?
Yeah, she had my age wrong. Colin goes, that's not his age, Mom. Is that okay? I'm like, yeah.
Did you think you were younger or older?
She thought I was older, so I shaved my beard. Anybody notice?
Yeah, it looks
oh
good.
Oh, my gosh.
You look like a baby.
Thanks.
Right.
Thanks.
Yeah. Brian's the last one to say something.
I have to Google my age all the time. My age, my wife's age, we're just so, we both do it. We're bad with numbers.
I don't know how you guys are that bad at your age. You're a young guy. I can see as you get older, maybe Googling your age or something like that.
I think it's because we're so close. I'm 37 and she's 36. Right. So sometimes, like, those two numbers will just, like, bounce around in my head, like, wait, am I 36 or is she 36?
Right.
Like, wait, is she 37? Or, like, I don't know. Right. I just.
Well, so you're 36 and you'll be 37 on July 4th. No, July 5th. July 6th.
July 3rd.
July 3rd.
July 5th.
July 5th? That's very
July 5th is my birthday, yes.
Right. Gotcha, okay. Brian, when's your birthday?
May 16th. Just like Janet Jackson.
Is Janet Jackson? Wow, that's great. Well, mine's in 2 days. Good morning, Patricia. How are you doing today?
Good morning, Val. How are you? I'm doing great.
Well, I got Kevin at his house and Jill at her house, too.
Hello, good morning.
Hi, Patricia. Oh, hi, you guys. How are you?
Good. Well, thank you.
So we talked about phones that give us phantom vibrations. Like the phone's not in our pocket, but we feel like we have the vibration and it freaks us out. I swear to you, it's a real thing. I will
sit
and feel, in my pants pocket, a phone going off and there's no phone in my pocket.
I have never experienced that, ever.
Yeah, I've never had the phone vibrations before.
What do you have?
I haven't had them in a couple of years. My kids are older now, but phantom kicks. They're pregnancy kicks almost. They mimic pregnancy kicks, but they're just phantom kicks. There's not actually anything in there kicking you. It's just it's just that sensation of getting kicked. I had three boys back to back, so I was pregnant for like 3 years. So after all my pregnancies, I would still get that sensation every now and then, and for a while I wasn't even sure what it was. Like, I would get that feeling and be like, weird, right? And a couple years later, someone mentioned it to me, so I looked it up, and sure enough, mothers can actually still have that sensation of kicking in their belly, even though there's nothing there. It's almost like your body's just mimicking that sensation.
Hmm. What if it's your body remembering the trauma of some kid kicking you?
Mm-hmm. Well, it does hurt.
Does it really hurt?
No, not the phantom kicks. The phantom kicks is just like, you know what it feels like if I wanted to, you know, like if you're chewing bubble gum and you like try to blow a bubble but you don't open your mouth, so like you're just blowing a bubble up against your lips from the inside of your mouth, and then it just pops. Yeah, that little bit of pressure and then the pop, and then it's gone. It's like that little sensation of like, oh, it's there, and boom, it's gone.
Thank you. It doesn't feel like anything else. Like, you can't confuse that with, like, oh, I have to go to the bathroom, or, you know, there's no other sensation that feels like it?
No, you know, sometimes you can get confused, like, oh, you know, oh my goodness, gas, you know, like, oh, am I going to fart? But no, it's
she said
like,
it, not me.
You took her down that road. You took her down that road, man.
Hey, that's what it's like when you're pregnant, though. You don't know what it is, you know?
Right.
You find out after.
Oh, good morning, everybody. Good morning. Well, Patricia, listen, thanks for calling. You're very sweet, and thanks for chatting with us. We really appreciate that.
Awesome. Thank you, guys. I'll talk to you guys later. Take care and have a wonderful day.
You too. Take care.
You too.
Does anybody else feel the phone thing? 31043.
Valentine in the morning.
1043, my FM.
Heard the good news about COVID-19 vaccines? Yeah, they're coming. But you can do a lot more than just wait. See, you have the power to help slow the spread. Actually, you can be a real difference maker and protect your family and loved ones, too. Here's how. Watch your distance. Stay at least 6 feet away from folks you don't live with. And it's risky to be indoors with them, too, no matter how far apart you are. And, of course, avoid crowds. Also, wear a mask. CDC reports that masks protect both the person wearing them and the folks around them from particles that carry the virus. And wash your hands using soap and water for 20 seconds, and do it frequently. Watch your distance, wear a mask, and wash your hands. Simple, effective, and along with vaccines, they're how you can make a big difference.
Learn more about vaccines at cdc.gov/coronavirus. Brought to you by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services.
Need a good laugh? Then stop everything and check out the funniest new podcast of the year. I'm talking about This Is Important, the podcast